Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Fluid Mechanics and Machines. And this is lecture number 13.1, 13th chapter, first lecture. We are going to discuss about the reciprocating pump in the 13th chapter. So the topic for discussion in this lecture will explain about the reciprocating pump. We classify the reciprocating pump, working and the work done of the reciprocating pump, coefficient of discharge, slip and the indicator diagram of the reciprocating pump. In the earlier chapter, we discussed about the centrifugal pump. So, the working of the centrifugal pump, the design parameter of the centrifugal pump, efficiency, everything we discussed about the centrifugal pump. And in this lecture, we are going to talk about the reciprocating pump. The learning outcome for the student, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to explain the working of reciprocating pump, define slip of the reciprocating pump, define coefficient of discharge of the reciprocating pump, and describe the indicator diagram of the reciprocating pump. Reciprocating pump is a positive displacement pump, in which the piston or the plunger is reciprocating inside a cylinder. So, the positive displacement machine and the rotary machine, there are the major two classification. So, in the rotary machine, so what we discussed earlier, the centrifugal pump in the previous chapter, we can close the delivery valve and we can run the centrifugal pump. That is what the rotary type of machine. For positive displacement machine, so the outlet valve, delivery valve should be in open condition before we start the reciprocating pump. That is the condition for reciprocating pump. The reciprocating action of the piston in the cylinder sucks the liquid and raises to a higher pressure and deliver it. So, the reciprocating action, like your internal combustion engine, the piston is reciprocating inside the cylinder. Piston or the plunger is reciprocating inside the cylinder. So, which is drawing, there will be a suction stroke and the delivery stroke. So, during the suction stroke, the liquid is drawn into the cylinder, and during the delivery stroke, the piston will be pushing the liquid with a higher pressure and it will be delivered. The amount of liquid pumped is equal to the volume displaced by the piston. So, the volume covered by the piston, it is what the volume amount of liquid pumped by the liquid. The reciprocating pump is also called as piston pump or plunger pump. The piston pump is normally designed to create pressure up to 25 bar, but the plunger pump can be built for a still higher pressure. So, look at the two different diagrams. The first one is the piston pump and the second one is the plunger pump. So, there is a piston which is reciprocating inside the cylinder. So, we have an inlet valve here. So, this is one-way valve. So, when the vacuum is created in the cylinder, the valve will automatically open and the liquid will be admitted into the cylinder. When the piston is moving downward, so the valve will be automatically closed because of the pressure rise. And on the other side, when the pressure increases, this delivery valve will open and the liquid will be discharged to the delivery pipeline. So, this is the suction pipeline or the inlet pipeline and this is the delivery pipeline. And here, if you look at the piston is closed, tightly reciprocating, tightly fitted to the cylinder, and there will be a small gap. So, using the gap, the piston will be reciprocating inside the inside the cylinder. But in the case of plunger pump, so there is a gap. So, there is a gap between the piston, plunger and the cylinder. So, the volume of the liquid handled by the plunger type of pump is more than the piston type of pump, and the pressure rise is also higher in the case of plunger type of pump. So, the inlet valve and the delivery valve, there is no valve actuating mechanism. They open and close depending on the pressure inside the cylinder. When during the suction stroke, vacuum is created, the pressure inside the cylinder decreases. So, this valve is opened here and this valve will be closed. So, because of the downward force, the valve will be closed and the inlet valve will open and the liquid will be entering into the plunger, entering into the cylinder. When the piston is moving downward, so, because of the pressure rise, the inlet valve will be closed and the delivery valve is open, high pressure liquid is delivered through the delivery pipeline. Next, we discuss about the classification of the reciprocating pump. The first classification, according to the suction of water. This may be single acting pump, so water is in contact with the one side of the piston, or double acting pump, so water is in contact with the both sides of the piston. So we'll explain the working of the single acting pump and double acting pump with the appropriate diagram in later slide. And based on the number of cylinder, this may be single cylinder pump, double cylinder pump, or the triple cylinder pump, depending on the delivery, the quantity of the liquid to be delivered and the pressure rise required, we may have single cylinder, double cylinder, or the triple cylinder pump. And according to the existence of the air vessels, so this may be, the pump may be with the air vessel or without air vessel. So preferably we have to use the air vessel so that there will be continuous delivery of liquid. Then this is the single stage reciprocating pump. So look at the diagram for few seconds and identify the various components, various parts of the single cylinder reciprocating pump. Single cylinder, single acting reciprocating pump. So we have a cylinder and we have a piston which is reciprocating inside the cylinder, and the piston is connected to the crank and the connecting rod with the shaft, crankshaft. So here a crankshaft is connected with the electrical motor, the power supply unit, and the crankshaft will be rotated. So when the crankshaft is rotating, the crank is rotating in the clockwise direction, and the piston is the connecting rod is oscillating, and the piston is reciprocating inside the cylinder. So in this position, so the piston is at the other end, right side end. This we have two dead center. One is inner dead center or IDC, outer dead center or the ODC. Now here it is near the inner dead center. Now as the crank rotates, the piston is moving backward. When the piston is moving backward, so here the inlet valve, so this is the suction valve, and you have a suction pipeline, and the water here, so the water sump level, sump or the well is here, so we have the sump water, the sump level, and this is the delivery pipe, and the delivery pipe is connected to the tank where we want to supply the liquid. And the center of the pump, center of the cylinder, so from the center of the cylinder, the height between the water level in the suction, water level in the sump, and to the center of the pipe, center of the cylinder, it is called a suction head. So HS is the suction head. And similarly, from the center of the cylinder to the top of the water level in the delivery tank, it is called as delivery head. And you have a delivery valve at the entrance of the delivery pipe, and you have a suction valve at the end of the suction pipeline. So when the piston is reciprocating from the right side to the left side, from IDC to ODC, the piston is moving backward towards the right side, so the vacuum is created. So the pressure decreases, vacuum is created. So when the vacuum is created, the suction valve will automatically open and the liquid will be rushing to the cylinder. When the piston is on the ODC, outer dead center, the piston position will be here and the cylinder is completely filled with the water. Now in the second stroke, delivery stroke, the piston is moving from ODC to IDC. So piston is moving from the right side to the left side. As the piston moves here, the delivery valve already is it is closed. When the piston is moving towards the left side, the liquid inside the cylinder is compressed. So the pressure is increasing. As the pressure is increasing, the suction valve will be automatically closed. So when the pressure further increases, so because of the pressure difference, the delivery valve open and the water is supplied to the delivery pipe and to the delivery tank. When the piston is coming to the IDC, again the piston is in this position, the lefty extreme position, and then the next suction stroke continues, and the water will be supplied, drawn into the engine cylinder, compressed and then delivered. And the distance, reciprocating motion between the two dead center, IDC and the ODC, is called as stroke length of the cylinder, and you have the diameter of the cylinder. So from the diameter and the stroke length, we can calculate the volume of the liquid handled or the volume of the liquid delivered by the single acting reciprocating pump. Now you look at this diagram. This is double acting reciprocating pump. So the similar arrangement we have the piston which is reciprocating inside the cylinder, and we have two suction valve and two delivery valve, delivery pipeline on both sides of the piston. So here we have S1, D1, this is X1 suction valve 1, D1 is the delivery valve 1, and D2 is the delivery valve 2 and S2 is the suction valve 2. So in the earlier single stage single acting reciprocating pump, so in every one revolution of the crankshaft there will be one delivery, one time the water will be delivered. But here for every stroke, for every revolution of the crankshaft, there will be two delivery. So delivery valve 1 will deliver the water and the delivery valve 2 is also delivering the water. So there will be continuous delivery of water in the case of double acting pump. So when the piston is moving from the left side to the right side, so the water in this on the right side of the piston, it is getting compressed and the delivery valve is open and the water will be delivered. So at the same time on the left side of the piston, the vacuum is created, the suction valve opens and the water will be admitted into the engine cylinder, into the pump cylinder. When the piston is on the extreme right side, so the water will be delivered. Now it is moving from the right side to the left side. When the piston is reciprocating from the right side to left side, so the water or the liquid in the left side is getting compressed and the pressure is increased. So the suction valve S1 is closed and D1 will be open and the water will be delivered here. At the same time, so here on the right side, the suction valve will open because of the vacuum created here. The suction valve will open and the liquid will be supplied to the drawn into the cylinder on the right side. So there will be continuous supply of water, continuous in every stroke there will be suction and one side there will be suction and another side there will be delivery. So there will be continuous delivery of water in the case of double acting pump. And from this diagram you can understand the suction single acting pump, there will be one delivery. So this is what the delivery actually during the suction stroke from 0 to 180 degree, the water is drawn inside. Next stroke 180 to 360 degree, the water will be compressed and then delivered. So in a single acting pump, the delivers the liquid once in a cycle, whereas the double acting pump discharges water twice in a cycle. So during this double acting pump, there will be delivery. So there will be suction in one side and delivery on the other side. There will be suction on one side and delivery on the other side. So there will be delivery from both sides of the plunger, both sides of the piston. There will be continuous supply of water or the liquid in the case of double acting pump. The discharge of liquid in single acting pump is intermittent. So there will be intermittent supply of water or the liquid in the case of single acting pump, whereas in the double acting pump, the discharge of the liquid is more uniform. Continuously, there will be supply of water. And we have to calculate the work done in a single acting pump. So we take the different parameters. D is the diameter of the cylinder in meter. A is the cross-sectional area of the cylinder, which is pi by 4 D square in meter square. N is the speed of the crank in RPM revolutions per minute. L is the stroke length in meter. H is the height of the center of the cylinder above the liquid surface in the sump. This is called a suction head. HD is the height of the center of the cylinder to the surface level of the liquid in the delivery tank, which is also in meter. This is called as delivery head. So HS is the suction head, HD is the delivery head. The weight of the water handled or the weight of the liquid delivered per second. So W equal to specific weight into volume of the cylinder in the speed of the pump. So specific weight equal to W, small w, volume of the cylinder equal to area into stroke length. So area is pi by 4 D square, L is the stroke length, and the speed of the pump, N in RPM, revolutions per minute, and this 60 is to convert the revolutions per minute into revolutions per second. So the weight of the water delivered by per second equal to WALN by 60 in newtons per second. And the work done per second or the power required to drive the pump equal to weight of the liquid lifted into total height through which the liquid is lifted. So the power equal to WALN by 60 is the weight of the liquid into the height is HS plus HD. So HS is the suction head and HD is the delivery head, and the power equal to Newton meter per second or watts or in kilowatts. We calculate in kilowatts. And the work done in the double acting pump. So again, we take the diagram of the double acting pump. So here we have the capital D is the diameter of the cylinder as we defined earlier. Now we have to consider here on the right side the diameter of the piston, small d, and the cross-sectional area of the piston is equal to pi d square by 4. Small d is the diameter of the piston rod. Now the volume of the liquid delivered in one revolutions of the crankshaft is equal to A into L. So A into L at one side, plus A minus A into L. So A is the cross sectional area of the cylinder minus A is the small a is the cross sectional area of the piston into L. So A equal to pi by 4 d square and small a equal to pi by 4. So A minus A equal to pi by 4 d square capital D square minus small d square into L is the stroke length. Now discharge of the pump per second. So this is the discharge in meter cube. Now we have to calculate the discharge in meter cube per second. We have to multiply by the speed of the pump. So the volume of the liquid delivered in 1 revolutions of the crankshaft into n by 60. N is the speed in RPM divided by 60 to convert minute into second. So pi by 4 d square into plus pi by 4 capital D square minus small d square into L into n by 60. That is the total volume of the total discharge from the double acting pump. If the diameter of the piston rod is very small compared with the diameter of the cylinder, then D square is neglected. So when the D square is neglected, the discharge will be equal to pi by 4 capital D square plus pi by 4 capital D square into L into N by 60, which is 2 into pi by 4 D square L N by 60, which is 2 into A L N by 60. So the discharge is 2 times the discharge of the single acting pump. So in the single acting pump, the discharge equal to A L N by 60. In the case of double acting pump, the discharge equal to 2 A L N by 60. Now the work done in the case of double acting pump. So the work done equal to work done per second or the power required to drive the pump equal to weight of the liquid lifted in the total height through which the liquid is lifted. So weight of the fluid lifted equal to W specific weight into discharge. So W specific weight into discharge equal to 2 A L N by 60 into head height equal to head equal to HS plus HD. So this equal to 2 times of W A L N by 60 into HS plus HD. So the if you look at the power required to drive the double acting pump, this will be 2 times of the power required for single acting pump. So then we discuss the coefficient of discharge of the reciprocating pump. The actual discharge in the reciprocating pump is always slightly less than the theoretical discharge. So theoretical discharge equal to area into L, pi by 4 d square into L. But the actual discharge will be slightly less than the theoretical discharge due to the reasons. Due to the reason like one, leakage through the valve, gland and the piston packing. There will be small leakage of water so that the discharge will be decreased. Imperfect operation of the valve. So the valve, it is not immediately opening and closing. There will be gradual opening and gradual closing. So there will be imperfect opening operation of the valve so that there will be loss of discharge. Partial filling of the cylinder during the suction stroke. So that is also possible because of the pressure difference between the suction line and the inside the cylinder. There will be partial filling of the water inside the cylinder during the suction stroke. So the ratio between actual discharge to the theoretical discharge is known as coefficient of discharge of the reciprocating pump, and it is defined CD equal to actual discharge divided by the theoretical discharge, which is Q actual by Q theoretical. So Q actual, it is the measured quantity of the liquid. So we using some flow meter, we measure the discharge through the at the outlet of the reciprocating pump. Q theoretical we calculate from the formula. So A L N by 60. So A L the area of the cylinder, stroke length into speed divided by 60. That is what the discharge, theoretical discharge. Then we calculate the slip of the reciprocating pump. The difference between theoretical discharge and the actual discharge is called as slip of the reciprocating pump. So slip equal to Q theoretical discharge minus Q actual discharge. Then the percentage of slip is given by theoretical discharge minus actual discharge divided by theoretical discharge into 100. That is what the slip. The slip calculation is important for the reciprocating pump. The percentage of slip will be less than 2% for well maintained pump. The slip should be minimum. So the slip minimum, that means the actual discharge should be closely equal to theoretical discharge. There should be minimum loss in the reciprocating, loss of water, loss of discharge in the case of reciprocating pump. In most of the reciprocating pump, the actual discharge is less than the theoretical discharge and the slip will be positive. In some cases, the actual discharge may be more than the theoretical discharge. In such a cases, the slip will be negative, called negative slip. The negative slip is possible in the case of pumps having long suction pipe and short delivery pipe, especially when these operating at a high speed. When the pump is operating at a high speed and long suction pipe, short delivery pipe, the slip will be negative. So, the actual discharge will be higher than the theoretical discharge. So, next we discuss about the indicator diagram. So, the indicator diagram of a reciprocating pump shows the pressure head of the liquid in the cylinder corresponding to any position during the suction and delivery stroke. The indicator diagram drawn by taking the stroke length in the abscissa and the pressure head in the ordinate. So, x-axis we take the stroke length and the y-axis we take the pressure head. And the ideal indicator diagram, this is what ideal indicator diagram. So, the ideal indicator diagram shows the pressure head with respect to the stroke length neglecting losses of head due to the effect of friction and the acceleration. So, we will explain the indicator diagram. So, the stroke length is taken here and the A to B is the suction stroke. So, A to B is the suction stroke and C to D is the delivery stroke and the center of the pipeline. So, the suction head is given by EF line is the center atmospheric pressure head which is 10.3 meter. So, the center of the cylinder. EF is the center of the cylinder or the atmospheric pressure head which is 10.3 meter. Now, the crank rotation. So, 0 degree crank angle when the piston is on the inner dead center IDC or the extreme left position. Now, the piston is reciprocating. The pressure inside the cylinder is less than the atmospheric pressure. As the piston is moving towards the right side up to the point B, this is called a suction stroke. The water is completely drawn into the engine cylinder, cylinder of the pump. Then the delivery stroke, now here it is 0 degree again we measure 0 degree crank angle from the outer dead center. Now the pressure is increasing. So it is acting at a higher head. So the pressure is increasing and the water is delivered with the higher pressure head. So the C to D is the delivery stroke. The piston is reciprocating from the outer dead center to the inner dead center and the pressure will be above the atmospheric pressure. HD is the pressure head above the atmospheric pressure. And the area of the indicator diagram has got the significance in the calculation of the power required for the reciprocating pump that we will discuss in the next slide. The line EF represents the atmospheric pressure head, H atmosphere equal to PA by W. So, PA is the atmospheric pressure, W is the specific weight of the liquid which is equal to 10.3 meter. The pressure head during the suction stroke is known as suction head HS, which is shown by the line AB below the atmospheric pressure head. And the height between EF and AB is the suction head. And the absolute pressure head during the suction stroke will be H atmosphere minus HS. So, head of the atmospheric pressure head minus the suction head. The pressure head is uniform throughout the suction stroke. The pressure head during the delivery stroke is known as delivery head HD, which is shown by the line CD above the atmospheric pressure head, and the height between EF and CD is called as delivery head. The absolute pressure head during the delivery stroke will be H atmosphere plus HD. So, atmospheric pressure head plus delivery head. The pressure head is uniform throughout the delivery stroke. These are all the description of the indicator diagram. And the work done per second by the pump is given by P equal to WALN/60 plus into HS plus HD. So, which is equal to WAN/60 into L into HS plus HD. So, WAN/60, W is the specific weight, A is the cross-sectional area of the cylinder and N is the speed, 60 is the conversion factor for seconds and L into HS plus HD. And the area of the indicator diagram ABCDA. So, AB into BC. So, AB into BF plus FC. So, BF plus FC equal to HS plus HD, which is L into HS plus HD. So, the power required to drive the pump, power required per second, work done per second, or the power required to drive the pump P equal to WALN into L into HS plus HD, which is equal to P equal to WAN/60 into area of the indicator diagram. So, this is the significance of the reciprocating pump. So, the power required is proportional to the area of the indicator diagram. So, it is a rectangle. Rectangle, we can simply calculate the area of the rectangle and multiplying with the specific weight area into speed that will give the power required to operate the pump. If the pump is double acting, neglecting the area of the piston rod, the work done per second is proportional to the twice the area of the indicator diagram. So, we draw the indicator diagram, multiply by 2, that is what the power required to operate the double acting reciprocating pump. So we stop here. So we will continue in the next lecture. Other topic in the reciprocal demand, next lecture we stop here. And these are all the books I published in the mechanical engineering subject, and you may find fluid mechanics and machinery which will be useful for you to get further information on this subject and to get more information on solving problem. So you refer the book, and I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the subject. You subscribe the channel and use the video lectures for your better learning and to pass in the GATE examination. So thank you for watching. So please post your comments on the comments box. You subscribe the channel and write to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. I will clarify, respond to your queries immediately. So thank you. We will meet again in another video lecture about the reciprocating pump.